So today's class we are already seeing number system, and now we are going to see the book exercises. Can we start with the video?
So in today's class we are going to see the exercise problems. So exercise 1.3. So the first question is, write the following in decimal form and say what kind of decimal expansion each has. So the question here is, we need to convert this fractional number into a decimal form, and we need to say whether it is a terminating rational number or terminating recurring rational number or terminating non-recurring rational number or any irrational number, that is non-terminating, non-recurring, irrational number. So we need to be specific. So all these divisions we have already seen in the video. So I'm going to go directly how to write terminating decimal, non-terminating decimal, and how to name them based on these decimals. So the first one is 36/100. So you must have already studied about the decimal division. So how to convert a fractional number into a decimal form. So here I will say how to do it. So if you have zeros, so first calculate how many zeros are there. So write 36 as it is. So this 36 as a whole number means there is a decimal point after this number. So this is the form. So since I have two zeros, if I need to convert this into a decimal form, I need to bring this decimal to the front. So what will I get? I'll get 0.36. Now I have converted this whole number into a decimal number. I hope it is clear. So now I have converted this into 0.36, that is a decimal number. Now I need to say what kind of decimal expansion is this. So we have already seen the definition of rational, irrational numbers, terminating and non-terminating numbers. So here I'll just give a small explanation. So terminating decimal means the number which stops. So the decimal point has to stop. Non-terminating decimal means the decimal number after the decimal point will never stop. It goes on infinitely. So based on this definition, I can say this is a terminating decimal. So now I have found out the decimal number and the name of the decimal number also. So the first sum, I hope you can understand. So first you need to convert it into decimal expansion. After decimal expansion, you need to find what decimal it is. That is, we are going to give the name, specific name for the decimal. So if it is a terminating decimal, the decimal point, that is the number after the decimal point, will definitely stop. It will have a definite number, that is finite number of steps. But in case of a non-terminating recurring decimal, you will have the decimal numbers, that is, and the numbers after the decimal point will go on infinitely and they will never stop. So this is the difference between both the thing. Now I'm going to go for the second sum. So the second sum is 1/11. So 1/11 can be done by simple division. So here 1/11. So for this 1 is smaller than 11. So I'm going to put a decimal point, add 0 here. So this 10 will not go in 11. So again, I need to add a 0 and put a 0 here. Now it is 100. So 11 9s are, it is 99. So if I'm going to subtract, take 1, carry over, 10 becomes here and it becomes 9. So here it becomes 1, 0. Now I need to add a 0. So 10 will not go in 11. Again, I need to add a 0 here. Then only I can add a 0 here. Then again it goes by 99, and the remainder is 1. So this division, you can see it is going on. So my answer is 0.0909 and so on. So this can also be written as 0.0 9 bar. So if this bar comes, then definitely it is a non-terminating decimal. So non-terminating. So you can see, so after this I need to write whether it is recurring, that is repeating or non-repeating. So recurring or non-recurring, or repeating or non-repeating. So this 0.09 is repeated. It repeats it in a sequence. So therefore you have to say it is a repeating decimal. Repeating or recurring decimal. Is it clear, children? Now let's go to the next problem. So the next problem is, you know that 1 by 7 is 0.142857 bar. Can you predict what decimal expansion of 2 by 7, 3 by 7, 4 by 7, 5 by 7, 6 by 7 are without actual doing of the long division? So here they have asked you not to do long division. So without doing this, they have given the only clue that they have given is 1 by 7. So they have given the clue. So 1 by 7 is equal to 0.142857. So with this clue, they have asked us to find 2 by 7, 3 by 7, 4 by 7, 5 by 7. So here, first I am going to write what is given. So they have given 1 by 7 is equal to 0.142857 bar. So the question what they have asked, so the solution is, they have asked you to find 2 by 7. So this 2 by 7, I can write it as 1 by 7 into 2. Can I write it like that? Yes. So I know the value of 1 by 7. So it is 0.142857 bar into 2. So if I am going to multiply, will I get the answer? Is this easy now? Children, can you give me the answer now? So if you multiply 0.142857 into 2, what is your answer? So now check the answer. It is 0.285714 bar. Is your answer correct? So now can we go for the next one? It is 3 by 7. So 3 by 7 also, so we have to separate it. 3 into 1 by 7. So if you are going to multiply, what you will get? You will get 3 into 0.142857. So now can you just multiply and give me the answer? So check the answer now. It is 0.428571 bar. So is your answer correct? What you have got? So the next one. So write it as this 1, 2. Then go for the third one. So the third one is, you need to find for 4 by 7. So this separated, 4 into 1 by 7. So if you multiply, come on, give me the answer. So please check your answer. It is 0.571428 bar. So please don't leave the bar, because if you leave it, then it becomes a terminating decimal. Then the whole sum will be wrong. So now we go for 5 by 7, which is 5 into 1 by 7. Children, give me the answer. Next one is 6 by 7, which is equal to 6 into 1 by 7. So the answer for 5 by 7 is 0.714285 bar. And similarly for 6 is 0.085 7142 bar. Is it clear? Can you understand? So in the previous problem we were seeing that converting a fractional number into a decimal number, so that we already know, but now this case is totally different. So you can see that they have given you a decimal number, and that decimal number we need to convert it into a fractional form. So how to convert this? So here you have it is 0.6 bar. So 0.6 bar, first we need to convert it into a decimal point. So how can you convert? So 0.6 bar can be written as 0.666666, so on, because this bar is nothing but the corresponding decimal is being repeated continuously and infinitely. So that is the meaning of it. So I have just separated, I have taken this bar away, and instead of that bar I have written that the decimal is being repeated again and again, that is 0.66666 and so on. So now I'm going to name it as x. So x is equal to 0.66666 and so on. So what is my question? My question is, I need to convert into p by q form. So to convert into p by q form, I should not have this decimal number. So this decimal number, I need to eliminate it. So how can I eliminate this zero? Whatever I do with zero, I'll get same zero. So to eliminate this zero, I'm just going to multiply by 10. So if I multiply both sides by 10, say multiply by 10. So if I multiply, take this as 1. Okay, so it becomes 10x, which is equal to 6.66666, so on. So this becomes my second equation. So now I'm going to subtract the second from the first. So subtract 2 and 1. So now 10x is equal to 6.6666, so on. And x is equal to, so this x can be written as 1x, 0.6666, so on. So now I'm going to subtract. So if I subtract, I'll get 10 minus 1 is 9x, and here I'll get the 6 as it is, and this will become 0, 0, 0, and so on. So now can you see I have eliminated the decimal point. So after the decimal point I have only zeros. So if it is zero, then it's not a problem, because zero cannot be considered if it is going to be after the decimal point. So now bring this 9 to the denominator. So my x becomes 6/9. So can you see that I have converted the decimal number into a fractional number? I hope you can understand. Now let's get into the second problem. So the second problem is, you can see the first problem was 0.6 bar. So after the decimal point I had only one digit and one bar. It was very easy for me. But in this case I have two digits, but my two digits does not have bar. Only one digit there is bar. So this first I need to convert it into a decimal form. So 0.4. So here 4 doesn't have a bar, so I'm going to write only once. Only the 7 has bar, so I'm going to write 7 repeatedly and going to put a dot for it. So only 7 is repeating here. So now I'm going to name it as x. 0.4777, so on. So this is my first equation. So now I'm going to multiply my first equation by 10. So it is 10x is equal to 4.7777, so on. So this is my second equation. So you might wonder, we are multiplying by 10, I'm getting a decimal, that is a number before the decimal point and also after the decimal point. So how can I eliminate this 7 now? It's very easy. So now I'm doing this because if I'm going to subtract this 7 and 4, definitely I'll get a number. So in order to eliminate that subtracted number, I'm first multiplying it by 10, and then again I'm going to multiply by another 10. I'm going to multiply this equation 2 by 10. It's okay. So now my second equation becomes 100x is equal to 47.7777, so on. Now I am going to subtract this third equation and second equation. So you can see I am not doing anything with the first equation. I am just doing taking second and third. This is because I need to eliminate this decimal number. Okay, so the 777, only if it is of same form I can eliminate it. If I'm going to have a separate number 47 or some other thing, it's not possible for me to eliminate, because during subtraction I'll definitely get some numbers. So now 100x is equal to 4.777, so on. Similarly, 10x is equal to 47.777, so on, and it is 4.777, so on. So if I'm going to subtract, I'll get 90x, and here I'll get, so 0, you will get 43.0000, so on. So now my x becomes 43 divided by 90. So I'm writing the answer again here. So here my x is equal to 43 divided by 90. So this is my fractional form. Is it clear, children? Now let's go to the next question. So the next question is, write three rational numbers whose decimal expansion are non-terminating, non-recurring. So we know that a decimal, if it is non-terminating, and non-recurring, it is nothing but an irrational number. So you should be more specific, and you should know what is an irrational number and a rational number. So a rational number will have non-terminating recurring decimal and terminating decimal. But in case of irrational number, there is only one option, that is non-terminating and non-recurring decimal. So from this itself, it is understood that we need to write irrational number. So what are all irrational numbers? Irrational numbers are root numbers. So now you see the value of root 5. So value of root 5 is 2.236, and so on. And value of root 7 is 2.6457, and so on. So you can see the numbers after the